During the pre-trial hearings, Ahmed testified and told the horrifying story of his torture in the Saudi prison. He also demonstrated to the court the way in which he was tied and beaten before he gave the forced confession. The defense attorney motioned to suppress the videotape of the confession based on the fact that it was extracted under torture. Judge Lee's response came in support of the government's pursuit and in a display of his personal biases, taking a position against Ahmed and abusing his discretion by attacking Ahmed's credibility without basis or reasoning, stated, quote, "The testimony of Mr. Abu Ali raises questions that bear on the defendant's credibility," unquote. The judge asserted that Ahmed had not been tortured in Saudi Arabia and that the confession was not coerced, though he provided no basis or reasoning for such a conclusion. Judge Lee denied the motion to suppress the videotape of the confession, and it was admitted into evidence. During the trial, Ahmed's torturers were allowed to testify with anonymity, not under the threat of penalty of perjury, and without the possibility of direct confrontation of the accused, as required by the Sixth Amendment of the Constitution. The testimony was done via video conferencing from Riyadh with anonymous witnesses protected by their government. In addition, although the judge allowed expert doctors to examine Ahmed for signs of torture, he introduced the report of the government's expert witness on torture to the jury, while barring the defense expert's report from being introduced to the jury during the trial. The judge also denied the defense motion for the testimony of key witnesses who were involved in the case from the beginning, while granting the government motions for all of its witnesses. During the closing statements, the prosecutors told the jury that if Ahmed were to be released, he would, quote, "kill us," unquote, pointing to the jury and himself, a remark prohibited by law from any prosecutor to any group of jurors under any circumstances, the legal consequence of which should have been a declaration of mistrial. Instead, the judge allowed this to happen two more times before he threatened the prosecutor that he will declare a mistrial if, quote, "you repeat the statement," unquote, addressing the prosecutor for the third time. On November 22, 2005, before Thanksgiving break and after deliberating for only 2.5 days, the jury returned a guilty verdict on all counts. Ahmed's charges carried a minimum of 20 years and a maximum of life in prison. During the sentencing hearing, the judge remarked about Ahmed's good character and clean record, as he referred to the hundreds of supporting letters that the community sent to the court, as well as Ahmed's guard's testimony to the court regarding his model behavior. For these reasons, the judge decided to sentence Ahmed to 30 years in prison, despite the prosecutor's insistence on a life sentence. Contradictory to his earlier claim that Ahmed lacked credibility, Judge Lee praised Ahmed's character and background. In June of 2007, Ahmed appealed his conviction to the Fourth Circuit Court on several grounds, and the prosecutors cross-appealed to increase the sentence to life in prison. A year later, the Fourth Circuit Court returned its opinion and rejected Ahmed's appeal with a 2-1 vote, thereby affirming the conviction. The justices also granted the prosecutors cross-appeal and reversed district court's sentence, advising the court to resentence Ahmed to life in prison. The defense then appealed the case to the Supreme Court, which refused to hear it in February of 2009, despite clear constitutional violations that the appeals court declared harmless error. Today, our beloved brother, son, and friend is languishing in Colorado's maximum security prison, known to be the second worst corrections facility only after Guantanamo, where he spends 23 hours a day in solitary confinement and is only allowed correspondence and very limited, infrequent, and irregular visits with his family. Ahmed plans to file a writ of habeas corpus to challenge his detention. The district court scheduled a hearing date on May 18, 2009, for Ahmed's resentencing in accordance with the Fourth Circuit Court's ruling. While the justice system so far has failed Ahmed, his family, and the Muslim community, it is up to us to come together and support the best defense possible, so that perhaps Ahmed may finally find justice.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولنبلونكم حتى نعلم المجاهدين منكم حتى نعلم المجاهدين منكم والصابرين ونبلو أخباركم إن الذين كفروا وصدوا عن سبيل الله وشاقوا الرسول من بعد ما تبين لهم الهدى لن يضروا الله شيئا وسيحبط أعمالهم يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم إن الذين كفروا وصدوا عن سبيل الله ثم ماتوا وهم كفار فلن يغفر الله لهم فلا تهنوا وتدعوا إلى السلم وأنتم الأعلون والله معكم ولن يتركم أعمالكم إنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وإن تؤمنوا وتتقوا يؤتكم أجوركم ولا يسألكم أموالكم إن يسألكموها فيحفكم تبخلوا ويخرج أضغانكم ها أنتم هؤلاء تدعون لتنفقوا في سبيل الله فمنكم من يبخل ومن يبخل فإنما يبخل عن نفسه والله الغني وأنتم الفقراء وإن تتولوا يستبدل قوما غيركم ثم لا يكونوا أمثالكم.